I've done kind of a lot of research about Chavez and Maduro, and I was just wondering what your thought is about the United States' place in this, because as you said, a lot of people on the left side of the aisle have argued that most of it's our fault and we should have taken a different route, but I was just wondering what your perspective was.
Yeah, well, first thing, you have to look up what actually are the sanctions in place. And I personally, let me say, I support the U.S. sanctions, and I actually think we should do a lot more than we're doing. But what are the sanctions in place? They confiscated properties of people like the four criminals I showed you. Two of them are actually right now in jail. The nephews of Nicolas Maduro are in jail in New York City because they were trying to smuggle cocaine into the United States. Yeah, I mean, this is an international criminal organization. That is what socialist regimes are. So the sanctions are to confiscate the properties of these crooks, are to ban them from having relationships with U.S. banks and U.S. persons. If Americans get money from them, actually Americans are also legally in trouble from doing that, and that should be the case, right? And so that's the kind of sanctions. I'm not forbidden from sending money to my family. I'm not forbidden from helping people. In fact, Venezuelans are receiving a lot of money from abroad, and that's why they're not all starving. It's because they're receiving a lot of remittances. So this is not the same case as Cuban sanctions or Iranian sanctions. Truly, you know, if you're Venezuelan and you want to bring something from the United States and you are not a member of the regime, you can do that. So that's why I find no merit in the argument that sanctions have anything to do with the problems of Venezuela. I think sanctions are part of the solution to actually end this tyrannical regime that is the cause of our ills. Yeah.
Thank you.